ครับนมัสการนะพระอาจารย์ครับ
สวัสดีครับ
นมัสการได้ยินนะครับผม
ครับสวัสดีครับได้ยินครับส
น
ว
า
ัส
น
ดีครับ
นานๆได้ออกเขายังไม่ได้พูดครั้
ค
ง
รับผม
ครั้งที่สองครับอาจารย์อยู่ที่วัดสวนดอกนะครับ
อ๋อผมอยู่อยู่ที่ป่าแปครับ
อ๋อแม่แตงเลยแหละครับเนาะ
ครับแม่แตงครับผม
อ๋อมันได้คุยกันครั้งหนึ่งใช่ไหมฮะ
ครับผม
สาธุครับสาธุ
สา
ท
ธุ
ำงาน
ครับ
อันนั้นผมอยู่ในนี่รอเลยใช่ไหมครับโอเคครับผมนมัสก
ค
าร
ับ
ครับพระอาจารย์เมตตาเอาบันทึกเทปบันทึกไว้ด้วยใช่ไหมครับ
ตอนนี้น่าจะบันทึกอยู่ครับผม
เอาบันทึกเรียบร้อยเนาะครับ
ค
ผ
รับ
ม
ผม
เก็บไว้เผื่อเอาไว้ดู
ครับผม
ที่วัดป่าแปะนี่น้ำท่วมไหมครับที่ผ่านมา
ก็ท่วม
เอาเหรอเสียห
ครา ั
ย
บ
เย
ผ
อะ
ม
ไหมครับ
เสียหายก็ส่วนใหญ่เป็นไฟดับครับไม่ได้จะ
อ๋
ไ
อ
ม่มีอื่นเท่าไหร่
ไม่ร
ไฟ
ุนแ
ด
ร
ับ
ง
กับน้ำไม่ติดครับแต่ว่าก็จะมันก็จะทางเดินทางเดินด้วยแล้วก็รถมันก็จะโคลนบางทีมันก็จะเข้าไม่ได้โคลน
อ๋
ม
อ
ันเยอะ
อ
ติ
่
ด
า
ตลอด
แต่นี้ผมอาจารย์เห็นผมอยู่ใช่ไหมครับผมเปิดกล้องอยู่ใช่ไหม
เห็นครับเห็นครับผม
ได้
ชัดเจนครับ
โอเคก็สิ่งในสาประมาณเท่าไหร่8 คนใช่ไหม7-8 คน
หนึ่งสองสามสี่ห้าหกอยู่นะครับหนึ่งสอง
ประ
ส
มา
ี
ณ
่
นี้
ห้
รา อบคลาสก็ประมาณนี้ใช่ไหมครับอาจารย์
ถ้าครบน่าจะมี8ครับใช่น่าจะยังไม่ได้จริงๆแล้วท่านน่าจะมีแค่5อยู่ตอนนี้ครับสองสามสี่ห้าขาดน่าจะขาดไป3 ท่าน
ขา
ค
ด
ิ
ไ
ด
ป
ว่
ส
า
ามท่านเดี๋ยวผมลองแชร์อันนี้ก่อนนานแล้วไม่ได้แชร์นี่แป๊บหนึ่งนะครับ
ครับผม
เอ๊ะจากมันมีเดสก์ท็อปของผมอ่ะผมมาอยู่หน้าเดสก์ท็อปนี่นะครับแชร์เลยนะอ๋อเดี๋ยวนะครับเปิดหน้าเดสก์ท็อปนะครับผมเปิดตัวนี้ค้างไว้อยู่ผมต้องวางไว้หน้าเดสก์ท็อปใช่ไหม
แชร์ได้ไหมครับผม
เห็นนะครับเดี๋ยวผมลองแชร์นะครับหมายความว่าโอเคผมต้องปิดตัวนี้ก่อนตอนนี้โอเคตอนนี้ผมลองแชร์ในนี้นะครับ
มันจะมีปุ่มสีเขียวอยู่ตรงกลางครับผม
นะครับเอ๊ะมันอยู่ตรงไหนครับ
อ๋อเดี๋ยวผมคิดว่าผมต้องให้สิทธิ์ของท่านอาจารย์
อ
ก่
๋
ออ น
ครับผมให้ผมนะครับ
ปุ๊บลองดูครับมีปุ่มแชร์ครับ
นะครับ
ขึ้นไหมครับ
อันนี้ยังเห็นเฉพาะที่เป็นรูปของเราออกตรงนี้ใช่ไหมผมต้องไปกดตัวไหนนะที่มันใหญ่ๆอ่ะที่มันเจอเนี่ยนะครับเดี๋ยวนะอย่างนี้คืออันนี้มันขึ้นเฉพาะหน้าที่ผู้ชมมันเนี่ยเดี๋ยวผมต้องไปกดตัวไหนนะที่เห็นฟังก์ชันมันครบอ่ะ
มันจะเป็นปุ่มสีเขียวครับเห็นไหมครับวันนี้ผมเพิ่งให้ท่านอาจารย์เป็นโฮสต์
อ๋อเดินนะครับปุ่มสีเขียว อืมเอ๊ะทีนี้ตอนนี้ผมทำไมไม่เห็นหน้าไม่เห็นรูปผมด้วยโอเคเห็นมันไปอยู่ตรงไหนนะครับเดี๋ยวอืมอ๋อตอนนี้ครับมาละผมปิดไว้ผมลองแชร์ดูนะครับ
ครับผม
ตอนนี้มันบอกว่า Enter Screen เหรอแชร์ถึงไม่แชร์ Open System Setting เนาะยังไม่ได้เซตโอเคแล้วผมก็ไปที่ Security Pay อยู่พอผมยังไม่เคยทำตัวนี้มั้งเองไงดีนะผมส่งให้ท่านดีไหมเดี๋ยวนะผมกดแชร์แล้วมันก็ลงตรงนี้ว่าไงนะผมต้องไปที่ตัวนี่เริ่มเลยใช่ไหมครับ
ก็เริ่มได้เลยครับ
เลยนะครับ
แต่
ผ
ว
ม
่าเจอปุ่ม
เข้ามาแล้วใช่ไหมครับผมเจนเนอโรก่อนแล้ว
หรือว่าเดี๋ยวผมส่งเดี๋ยวผมดูวิธีเด
อ
ี๋ย
ั
ว
น
ผ
นี
ม
้
ดู
ผ
ล
ม
าย
ส่
ก
ง
่อ
ให้
น
อาจารย์ยังไงดีครับผมส่งให้ไปตรงไหนดีใน
เดี๋ยวแป๊บหนึ่ง
เพราะมีแค่สองแผ่นเองครับที่เดียว
อาจารย์ใช้ลายชื่ออะไรนะครับ
ลายผมชื่อส่งเสริมนะครับใช่ไหมครับส่งเสริมแสงทองเอ๊ะ
มีอยู่ในนักทำเลเวล2ไห
ม
ม
ี
ครั
ครับมีอยู่เนี่ยนะครับ
บเอ๊ะทำไม
นานๆใช้ครับโทษ
ไม่เป็นไรครับทำไมผมไม่เจอส่งเสริมแสงท
ครั
อ
บ
งในกลุ่มนักทำเลเวล2
ในกลุ่มนักธรรมใช่ไหมครับโครงการอะไรไม่ใช่อะไรนะครับมีไหมครับ
ไม่เจอเท่าไ
โ
ห
คร
ร่
งก
ครั
า
บ
รสอนนักธรรมอ่ะใช่ไหม23 คนเนอะโครงการสอนนักธรรมให้ต่างชาตินี่ใช่ไหมครับประเสริฐดอก
นักทำสตาร์ดี้อะครับ
อ๋อไม่มีครับดังนั้นนะผมมีแต่ภาษาไทย
อ๋อ
ที่โครงการสอนนักธรรมให้ชาวต่างชาติ23 คนอ่ะอันเก่าเริ่มใหม่ไม่รู้เพราะไม่ค่อยเห็น
น่าจะต้องเข้ากลุ่มใหม่ดึก
อ๋อครับโอเคการส่งเชิญผมนี่นะครับหรือว่าผู้ส่งให้อันเก่าก่อนที่นักโครงการสอนธรรมจะมีไหมครับ
ผมไม่มีกลุ่มนะ
อ้าว
ผ
เหร
ม
อ
ไม่มีกลุ่มนะเดี๋ยวแล้วถ้าอาจารย์แอดไลน์ผมก่อนก็ได้ครับ
ครับ
ถ้าผมส่ง
เดี๋ยวไม่เป็นไร
ลองแอดไลน์ที่ผมส่งไปในแชทให้หน่อยครับ
นี่นะครับ ในแชทของนี้ใช่ไหม
ครับในแชทอันนี้เลย
ซูมใช่ไหม
มีสองไอดีครับไม่แน่ใจว่าไหน
สองไอดีใช่ไหมครับเดี๋ยวส่งเข้าไปในนี่เลยได้ไหมที่แชทเนี่ยเปิดได้ไหม
หมายถึงส่งอะไรนะครับ
ส
ส่
่
ง
ง
ไฟ
ไฟ
ล
ล
์
์ครับครับ
ในแชทน่าจะส่ง
ได
ได
้
้อ๋อส่งได้
ส่งได้ไหม
แต่ผมส่งโค้ดให้อาจ
อ
า
๋
ร
อ
ย์แล้วอาจารย์ต้องส่งโค้ดกลับให้ผมหน่อย
อ๋อเหรอครับ
ตรง participant นะครับ
ปฏิสิทธิ์แผนเดี๋ยวแป๊บนึงครับ
แล้วก็อาจจะกดชื่อผมแล้วก็ make host
กดใช่ไหมครับ
งง
พั
ใช่ไหม
สนัยอะไรนะพัสนัย
ครับผมใช่ครับ
แล้วก็เป็นอะไรนะอินไวต์หรือไงนะไม่ม
แ
อ
ล้ว
ง
ก็เป็นโฮสต์ครับมันอาจจะขึ้น invite host หรืออะไรอย่างเงี้ย
อินไวต์นี่ใช่ไหมครับ
ครับผม
กดที่อินไวต์เนาะ
ครับผม
แล้วก็มาขึ้นมา Yahoo choose your email แล้วอันนี้
อ๋อไม่ใช่ครับการกดตรงชื่อผมข้างๆมันจะมีคำว่ามอครับ
มอใช่ครับใช่หมอละ
ครับผมแล้วมัน
ก
จ
็
ะมี
ก
ค
ด
ำว่า make post อะไรอย่างเงี้ย
ใช่ครับผมกดไปไม่โคตรเนาะโอเคครั
ค
บ
รับกดให้ผมเป็น make post
change code เนาะใช่ไหมครั
ค
บ
รับผม change post to โอเคทีนี้แล้วเดี๋ยวลองส่งไฟล์ให้ผมก็ได้
ส่งไ
ใ
ป
น
ที
แช
่ไหน
ทนี่เลย
ในแชทนี้เลย
ครับเดี๋ยวลองดู
โอเคครับได้ไหมครับ participant ในแชทครับ
ครับผมในแชทนี่ครับ
เดี๋ยวผมต้องส่งตัวไหนนะเดี๋ยวนะเฮ้ยทำไมอย่างนี้เนี่ยได้หรือยังโอเคไหน
ส่งมายังไม่ได้ครับผม
ไม่ผมไปกดตัวแชทใช่ไหมครับผมกดแชท
ค
ข
รั
ึ้
บ
น
ผ
มามแล้วก็ไปกดตัวไหนต่อนะมอเหรอ
แล้วก็ไอ้ตรงสามจุดครับมันจะมีคำว่าไฟล์ครับข้างล่างครับมันจะมีรูปหน้ายิ้มโมจิแล้วก็ไฟล์
อ๋อ3 จุดด้านบนใช่ไหมครับ
ด้านล่างครับผม
พอ
มัน
ผ
จะเ
ม
ป็นสี่มันจะเป็นไอคอนนะครับอยู่ประมาณ4 อันด้านซ้าย
ด้านซ้ายมีแต่ตัวทีเดี๋ยวนะข้างล่างใช่ไหมมันมีฟอร์แมตมีรูปอีโมจิแล้วก็มีออไฟล์ใช่ไหมครับ
ครับผม
โอเคผมกดไฟล์
กดตรงซ้ายครับ
ตกไฟล์แล้วก็ผมไปมันกำลังโอเคแบบนี้ครับโอเคโอเพนนะครับแต่จะไปแล้วใช่ไหมครับ The Tree ยานะนะครับโอเคอยากขึ้นให้ผมไปก็ได้ครับโทษครับคือ4 โมงครึ่งน้องเขาถ่ายไป10 นาทีได้เช่นครับจานโปรดให้ผมเลยก็ได้นั่นแหละโอเค
โอเค
ไม่เป็นไร
ได้แล้วนะครับได้
ได
แ
้
ล้ว
ครับได้ครับตามนี้นะครับ
โอเคครับ
เริ่มเลยนะครับ
ครับผม
ขอบพระคุณครับผม
ครับผมไม่เป็นไรครับ
โอเคGood afternoon, everybody. ครับ Good afternoon every participants I'm very happy to see you today for a long time นะครับอาจารย์ริชาร์ด very kind of him to be your good friend and teach you about the Dhamma right for this time also I'm yeah have opportunity to talk about the jhana insight and knowledge in Buddhism, right? We maybe talk about one topic, but we need more detail and discuss together among our participants. Especially today, we've been talks about the three jhana or insight and knowledge or super knowledge in Buddhism. That means these three jhana are the tools to enlighten the Four Noble Truths. Enlighten the Four Noble Truths. That is very important tool for human being to see the Four Noble Truths, to penetrate into the Four Noble Truths as they are and know what to do. As the one who will enlighten the Four Noble Truths. The Buddha also declared he himself as the Lord Buddha after his enlightenment of the Four Noble Truths through the three jhana. What are the three jhana? The three jhana or insight knowledge. The first one we call the Satya jhana, knowledge of the truths that they are. The second one, the Kichayana, knowledge the function with regard to the respective four, the four noble truths. The three Katayana, knowledge of what has been done with regard to the respective four, the four noble truths. That means the jhana or super knowledge in Buddhism to know the first Satyayana mean to know or to enlighten about the Four Noble Truths as they are. Because the Noble Truths are very important in Buddhism. If we know this truth, we enlighten this truth, we see this truth encourage us to realize and to develop ourselves to have more and more right understanding, right practicing, and then we can achieve the goal of enlightenment, mean can free from all kind of trouble, sufferings, or any problems, right? Caused by our own weakness of ignorant desire and attachment. So the Four Noble Truths mean the truth of suffering, the cause of suffering, the sensation of suffering, and the right way leading to cessation of suffering. The Satyayana means the knowledge of this first, the suffering of our body, the suffering of our mind, the suffering of our condition that after we due to or contact to the surrounding objects, we feel uncomfortable or unhappy. Because of our own craving, our own attachment, in both negative or positive way, until we know that is Satyayana to know the suffering, mental suffering, body suffering, or suffering caused by our contact to the environment objects, the form, the sound, the smell, the truth, the tongue, tangible object or mental object. When they occur, we have ignorant desire attachment at the root of suffering. We call the root of the cause of suffering, or the root of suffering we call samuttaya, right? And the third one, we know the cessation of suffering, the clean, clear, calm mind free from ignorant desire attachment, the state of freedom from clinging, craving, or attachment to any objects, Let see them as they are and associate them correctly until have no only conflict to on phenomena that's appearing to you นะครับ and know how นะครับ the right practice the right way of practice of cultivating about the right conduct right will right understanding right speed right action right livelihood right effort right mindfulness and concentration so as to achieve the state of freedom from suffering นะครับ that is a very important นะครับ in Buddhism so the first jhana me to know the suffering the cause of suffering the ending of suffering the end of suffering orThe cessation of suffering and the right path leading to the cessation of suffering, especially the path composed with the eightfold noble path or the middle way, or we can conclude into the three factors of life training about morality, behavioral training, mental training, and wisdom training. The way to cultivateThe support together about the factor of three training, behavioral training, mental training, and the wisdom training. And then we achieve the state of non-suffering at all at the Eightfold Noble Path. So this is the first jhana, the jhana to enlighten about the Four Noble Truths as they are correctly.Correctly. Don't think about all my suffering caused by the supernatural power, caused by the God power, caused by the fortune teller, caused by any luck or any hidden power, something like that. That means we don't know the Four Noble Truths as they are. We know our suffering caused by our weakness of ignorant desire attachment that we allow them to.Work and cultivate more and more before we don't know this. We don't know our power. Now, if we know our power of freedom from non-suffering state, and we know the right technique that encourages us to practice correctly to know the to free from all kind of suffering. The second one we call Kijayana.Kijayana means the function, knowledge of the function with regard to the respective the four noble truths. The Kijayana, the function, like the suffering, the suffering must be investigated by the learner or by the one who have suffering, right? Suffering not for solution, suffering not for cultivate, suffering not for...realize only because but for like the chapter that's for our learning when suffering occur both physical suffering or mental suffering that are the objects to be learned by ourselves so if we need to free from suffering we have to know the function of suffering นะครับThe function of the cause of suffering, the function of the suffering must be acknowledgement or must be realizing the suffering. The second one, like the cause of suffering, must be reduced, destroyed. The cause, like ignorant desire attachment, must be removed from our life. We have to prevent them.We have to stop them. We have to not support them, encourage them to growing up in our mind and body. But we have the function that we have to reduce, control, and destroy so as to let them disappear in our mind, our action, our behavior to contact to the object. Otherwise, we may contact to them in the wrong way and we have more and more.Craving and this attachment and desire. So how to discard, how do you reduce, destroy? This is the second function of the second knowledge of the Four Noble Truths. for the last the third one แล้วก็ we call nirodha or we have to penetrate into inside we have to realizing until very clear in our mind our experience that the cessation of suffering are very noble states that very important for human being very important for us as to go as a freedom of life at the non-suffering state that we have more power to free from all kind of suffering. Now let us have more power, clean, clear, calm mind, have the clean, clear, calm mind, and peaceful mind, and the mind of loving kindness and to all sentient beings correctly as they are. So we know that non-suffering state or Nirvana state or Nirodha state also are the state of non-suffering that human being can be achieved by human or realizing and be confident in the state, pick them as the goal of life, as the way that we have to do at the end of suffering that we have power to achieve this state. No one help you, we ourselves help ourselves by know that we have our own destination of non-suffering state of freedom from trouble or suffering at all, every time, everywhere, every movement of life. If we also practice correctly, we can achieve this state. We call Nirvana, Nirodha, Tathangka Vimutta, or sometimes we call Vimutta, or freedom from suffering at all. Okay. Says for the Kichayana of the last, the fourth noble truth, like eightfold noble path or the path, leading to cessation of suffering. Also, that the function of this knowledge that we have to cultivate, we have to develop the right system of practice. From our mind, our wisdom, our behavioral training, we call morality, the correct morality that we have to control our behavior, not killing, not stealing, not have sexual misconduct to other people, make suffering for oneself and other people. We have to continue right effort to prevent ourselves from suffering, effort to solve, to reduce, to solve the suffering, effort to develop, the right effort to the right practice of the Four Noble Truths, the effort that we have to maintain the correct practice in daily life activity, so as to cultivate the Eightfold Noble Path in our way of life, so as to leading to the end of suffering. So this is the function. The first function of suffering must be investigate and accept that we have the true suffering. Now, suffering about the problem, the symptom of suffering, the effect of the suffering, until we know all suffering are very suffer, very useless to live with them, and then we have to remove them. But we investigate on detail that they are related about the impact of the suffering, the state of suffering, impact of suffering, something like that. Until we know that suffering as under the name of suffering, we not want welcome at all, because we're dangerous for life. And we have to accept that we accept already about the suffering when they occur in our mind, our life. We fix already, we know them already. This is because we have to know the function. We have to run the right process or the right function of the Four Noble Truths correctly as they are. Suffering must be realized or acknowledged. The cause of suffering must be reduced, destroyed, or abandon นะครับ to forsaking all on of them as ignorant desire to attachment not support them นะครับ the end of suffering must be realizing and นะครับ penetrate into นะครับ that clearly the state of freedom until they inspire us to achieve the state of non-suffering that are very useful for human being ourselves and for the sentient being in the world นะครับ in the future clean clear calm mind state and freedom of non-suffering must be reached must be fixed as the goal that we have to run our life to achieve this one and the function the last one that we have to cultivate like the Eightfold Noble Path the middle way or the three training of life morality training mental training and wisdom training until we support each other about the threefold training of life together and then we can achieve the state of non-suffering by this right practice this is we call the second jhana of kitta jhana kitta means the functions with regard to the respective four noble truths and then we have to we have to as we have to check again that knowledge what we have been done with regard to respective for the four noble truth like we know the function and we have to assessment we have to assessment again about our function that we practice correctly to the four noble truth we know the four noble truth that they are at the first jhana we know the function that we have to do correctly with the four noble truth and then we have to check again our function are complete or not suffering must be investigate or acknowledge and accept we have done already we have accept already we know already we realize the chapter of this already in all detail and then we see the suffering until we accept that we cannot allow them to occur in our life again and again this is we call we check we have been done in we have the third jhana or kata jhana mean we know what we have to do and we know what we have done นะครับ our function have done already that is the first one for the cause of suffering must be destroyed remove forsaking and to remove them already check again that we remove already or not we destroy already or not นะครับ we remove them already or not if we not finish we cannot declare that we are enlightened one we have to remove them all in any time anywhere any place any conduct any contact when we contact to the world we have to not allow ignorant desire attachment of these four noble truths occur in our life that means we not attached not for attachment but for checking that we assess already that we correct we have done especially the third one the nirodha state we have to penetrate into we have to enlighten we have to be clear and have more inspiration to have power to work on the eightfold noble path นะครับ we have done already about our clear about the goal or destination of our practicing in daily life so as to walk into the right way correctly so as to achieve the goal that we have to cultivate we have to go we have to practice and the last one also check again that we have cultivated already for the Eightfold Noble Path the noble path or the three training of life skill like a morality mental development both mental practice samatha and vipassana bhavana and insight or wisdom to know them as they are destroyed about it ego super ego and destroy all about the suffering caused by attachment in the section pressure in the tradition or in the fashion of the world in the well of the world attachment and in ego and in the cell of the world or especially นะครับ and clinging to the idea the concept of self will the wrong will at all that we have more and more suffering so this is a very important that we call the three jhana the inside the three knowledge that the Buddha declared he himself so we have the trigger revolve knowledge and inside the three aspect of intuitive knowledge regarding the four noble truths if we have the three jhana or knowledge correctly to the four noble truths until there are about 12 factor of enlightenment three นะครับcalculate with the four and then equal to 12 factor นะครับ three jhana and four noble truths are the 12 factor of enlightenment if we practice according to this that mean we try to follow the Buddha teaching as the one who will be the Buddha Sasanika Chon as the Buddhist in Buddhism the Buddhist mean the one who have clean clear calm mind awakening one the one who have the correct system of living in the world and freedom from suffering อาจารย์เมตตาหน้าต่อไปได้เลยครับ taking knowledge and insight นะครับ so we can conclude that in enlightenment of the four noble truths with the three jhana we call กิจญาณะนะครับนะครับand like that we call กิจญาณะนะครับ like we call กิจญาณะกัตญาณะ three jhana or กิจญาณะ which mean three complete cycle of the insight the three kinds of knowledge and the pair of the activity of the four noble truths นะครับ become the knowledge that has been a symptom as the follow we can cultivate that one นะครับ I understand for the truth I suffering is this is a suffering นะครับ samuttaya this is the cause of suffering นะครับ nirodha this is the cessation of suffering the path leading to the path to the cessation of suffering is the first group of the satyayana know the four noble truths as they are the second jhana kicchayana also right we call kicchayana understanding duty to the noble truths and the suffering should be known should suffering should be known นะครับsamuttaya the cause of suffering should be abandoned nirodha the cessation of suffering should be made manifest okay the path and the path to the cessation of suffering should be practiced to develop that's a very important like a function that we have to know and practice and follow according to the Buddha because he declare he was the enlightened and he is the enlightened one because he enlightened the four noble truth with the three jhana นะสุดท้ายได้เลยครับ this are the third one katayana right now we can enlighten the four noble truth by this three knowledge นะครับ katayana mean knowing that we work that should have been done has been complete I suffering has we already been determined samuttaya cause of suffering has been removed right nirodha cessation of suffering has been revealed the path to the cessation of suffering has been practiced already check until we complete on function to the four noble truths and then we can declare that we are complete นะครับ the suffering because of we follow the right way of the practice according to the Lord Buddha teaching So I think it is that I just present you the information of the three yana. That's a very important for the Buddhist or for the human being who are confident, who are confident in human power of enlightenment. We know this technique and principle enlightened and taught by the Lord Buddha. Not only he himself enlightened, but after teaching this super knowledge to the first ascetic group, monk, and from that day to this day today, the one who know the four noble truths as they are, who know the right function that we know, we practice to the four noble truths as they are correctly, and then we have finished in our function that we done. We have done, that means we can call ourselves that we are enlightened one. The principle encourages human being to be the holistic scientific methods. Scientists, we can be scientists. The Buddhist scientists mean the scientist that we enlighten both the mental state, mental suffering, and physical suffering. We know how to behave ourselves correctly to these objects and phenomena as they are. That means we can live without suffering at all. So I just would like to present you at the first step that we can share together, we can discuss together about the three yana as the tool for human being to achieve the state of non-suffering. Okay, now I give the time for our friend in this room to ask, to discuss, to give any idea about this knowledge of the Four Noble Truths, please. Do you have any questions? Praise พระอาจารย์สนทวีด้วยใช่ไหมครับนมัสการครับเวลคัมสตูเดนท์เวลคัมพาร์ติซิเพนท์ you understand or not understand tell me and then share together again please we are enlightened already
thank
we
you
are enlightened okay please please yeah
Ajahn, I have not yet enlightened, so still
you
trying
have
to.
hope after learning this principle. You have hope.
Still trying to find out and trying to digest, and now my understanding is only like this three yana. We can only achieve through meditation practice, right? Just now, I also mentioned we also must practice our sila, practice our other parami well, must be diligent in so all the rest of the parami are like the helping factor, right? Factor to help us, but this jhana is the knowledge inside, isn't it? We have to achieve, we can only achieve through meditation. We can only see it in meditation, right?
We can conclude to in daily life practice, right? In daily life practice, when we contact to the world in the form, the sound, the smell, anytime, any moment, right? We can observe. Don't make the Buddha teaching as the special expert or special way or keep important for any one or two or three detail, but we have to conclude that like we cultivate the four Mahasatipatthana or insight meditation practice, mean we try to when we follow this, mean we have mindfulness, Mindfulness also at the root that encourages us to realizing about the three jhana cope with the four noble truths. Okay, we can check the mindfulness encourage us. So we can say that as the first step, we know already or not the suffering, because most practitioners, most Buddhists started with the Eightfold Noble Path, but without understanding the first suffering, or we call the first four noble truths, right? By this way, we have to start with the first one, like the Satyayana, not cultivate mindfulness to see suffering, but mindfulness or insight meditation at the last step, leading to non-suffering state, right? Leading to freedom from non-suffering. But the first step, if we need to remove suffering, we have to realize and accept that we have suffering or not. Because many Buddhists, many people, they don't start with the first step, but they may start from the fourth step first, something like that. Like we explain Dhamma in Thailand, also Kathu Dhamma or something, we need to explain the principle to explain, but they don't talk about the problem, the true problem, the true suffering that we have. So many Buddhists not understanding about suffering, not understanding about the cruel suffering that affected to our life and have more and more suffering in until we cannot let them live with us. The more we know enlightened the first step of the Four Noble Truths, the first one, then we fear of suffering. We need to escape from suffering. We need to search some good friend, any friend, to point out the way to walk from out from the suffering, right? So when as the Buddhist, the first one is very important. The first step, Satyayana, we know already that we have suffering in any level, in what level we have, right? The first is very important. So when we talk about the Paramita, when we talk about insight meditation, we talk about the Mahasatipatthana, we talk about the Eightfold Noble Path. We talk about the last one, that for the one who have known already about suffering they have, and they know already the cause of suffering that they not allow them to inside, right? But they walk out by the new pattern of life, of living, the new pattern of practice we call the Noble Path. The Noble Path will occur automatically when we fear of suffering. When we fear of the cause of suffering, we not allow them to occur more and more in our moment of life, in daily life. And then when we know the destination of the third one, of the Four Noble Truths, that inspire us a lot to cultivate, to have more power, not negative way, not why we have to do, why teacher have to control us, but to blame us again, and wake up early morning, something like that. We suffer, practice with suffering, because we don't know the aim of living, the third knowledge or the third noble truth, the nirodha or nirvana, as the very important, the coolness of mind, the freedom of mind, that is had the more power. If we initiate into deep, then we have already, wow, we live with a very meaningful of life. We live for freedom. We live for something like that. We don't have any structures about suffering, about why that one, that's the school, right or wrong, something or not. But if we are confident about the first one, that the first Satyayana, let us know that the function, let us have more technique, the correct technique to do. And the third one, we have to check and we have to assessment our practice again to complete or not complete in step by step. Yeah. Okay, ครับ please.
Thank you อาจารย์
Welcome, welcome, Kim Ma. Okay.
I want to find out another question, อาจารย์
Please.
The second slide, อาจารย์ mentioned about the complete, like you mentioned, suffering is complete and the all the four stages, right? Of noble, noble, four noble truth. So how do we come to this realization that suffering is no more? Is it we see it in the meditation?
Uh-huh. Yeah. The first one, when we have like meditation, is the tune to do, right? That we have to do, and to live at the present, back to the present, right? Back to the present mean if we not live at the present, we cannot see the suffering occurring at the present time. Buddhism is the middle way, mean not for the past, not for the future, not for negative or positive, living at the present to know them as they are, right? So how to live at the present, to investigate the suffering that's occurring at the present. We know the complete of suffering in any moment of suffering occurring at the present time. When we contacting the object, when we contacting from our eye consciousness, ear consciousness, nose consciousness, tongue consciousness, body consciousness, or mental consciousness, right? When they run the function of this, they have automatically worked at the function of the contact. We live at the present mean live and realizing the suffering will show us any contact. If we have wrong view, wrong understanding, we don't know the Buddha teaching before, we start contact, start clinging, start contact, start attachment. Start contact, start having feeling, happy a feeling occur, happy or unhappy. We have already attachment or clinging to the allow desire attachment occur again and again. But when we follow the first jhana, we have to know that all the cause suffering must be reduced, must be removed, must be retroid, right? Not support them. The mindfulness check us know that, oh, we have suffering because of this root. Check at the present. Living at the present is the answer to know the suffering occurring at the present time. And then the more we see, the more we know, the any movement, walking, sitting, or lying, or standing, any posture we have, we are practicing. This is we also realizing. If we are realizing the Four Noble Truths, that's what we call the first jhana. Set them, the group of them correctly, the condition of them related to each other correctly as they are before such a jhana. But whenever we know how to do, what to do about this, no, we have to redo, we have to be awareness, not allow desire attachment, not to dream, daydream, not to follow, not to create. I to see the famous, the like the fashion, the very expensive car passing us. We know that I have to buy. I maybe won lottery next time tomorrow, and I mean buy it 3 cars of this. Very expensive car, and I will be a millionaire. Something, but worry, we allow desire attachment create more and more sankhara. Okay, sankhara mean like thinking about this, not based on the truth, but based on desire attachment. So to live at the present, to know them as they are, suffering as they are, cause suffering when they occur, we know we all. Not allow, not thinking, not supporting, not. But by this way only we can enlighten the Four Noble Truths. Not by time, not by tradition that we go to the temple for 3 days a year and then we have to go separate the life from the present. Separate the life from, because we cling to the tradition, we cling to the Lokiya way of living. We have to extreme in the inside or outside, or expert or not expert in one tradition or practice or not. But when we back to the holistic in daily life, to live at the present, start learning the first satyayana, understand about the kichayana, know about what we have done and check our balami, mean what we have done until we have power enough to free from suffering, right? Balami, that we have cultivated already. We know our temperament, we know our power that we have. We know what we lack, king of, and then we search some good friend to share, to inspire, to have more power, นะครับ to talk about this clear and clear again until we are confident enough to use every movement of life to develop the satyayana, to develop realizing and accept the four noble truths that they are, right? To cultivate our living and practicing, we call kichayana correctly to the four noble truths, and then we check our practice again and again. The more we check, the more we know our palami, or we know what we have done for the correct practice, and then we have confidence to continue our practice in daily life. Yeah. Thank you, Kima. Understand? Okay. Yeah, please.
I have also one question, Ajahn.
Please.
So when we are reciting the Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta, right?
Uh-huh.
And I think we also are chanting those different stages, right? If, for example, like Dukkang,
mm-hmm.
we first start with Itang Dukkang Ariya Sajjantime. This is the Sajjayana, right?
Yeah, right.
And then they have level two is Tam ko panitam tukang ariya sajang parinya tanti me.
This is the kichayana. Yeah.
Yeah. Kichayana, yeah. And then
tam ko panitam suffering. Yes.
Tukang ariya sajang parinya tanti me.
Yes.
So this is like level three. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So this is making it more clearly for me. So yeah. We got like a conclusion from Prajana Rongchai, where he's like
uh-huh.
where he mentioned and put it into blocks so that we could like learn the Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta more easy. And now this with your explanation makes even more sense to me. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Very good.
The same thing, because Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta, the Buddha taught very clear step by step, right?
Yes.
Especially the 12 factor of enlightenment mean the jhana, the three jhana, right? And the four noble truth that we have to learn step by step. The first sermon of the Lord Buddha, Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta, he point out very clear to the five ascetic about what they have to do, right, for their enlightenment. Yeah, that is the pattern of Buddhists have to realize and follow. Like we bring only the three jhana to enlighten the four noble truths. I agree to you that the Buddha already point out and clear step by step of the jhana, the three jhana to the four noble truths in the Dhammacakkappavattana Sutta. Yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah. Very nice to hear that.
Thank you. Thank you. Welcome, Chair. After student participant, please together. So it's a way how to apply to daily life that is very important, not separate from the life, not separate because by opportunity, by time, by place, right? By place, I live in the temple or in the center, Only we practice meditation when we live in daily life, we allow desire attachment to control us as the big boss, right? So we have suffering again and again. We have no power because our big boss not allow us to free from them. They need to convince, control, and destroy us to be their slave. We have suffering. Why Buddha birth is suffering? Because we were born to search the right power of practice to free from the cycle of suffering, right? That we call samsara, what cycle of life. So when we know the Buddha, that is a very noble opportunity to understand our nature of life, our environment that come to make us have suffering by contacting at the present. So we learn Dhamma a lot, that means very important. You just apply the three jhana. Learn again and again, try to understand again and again, talk and maybe discuss together again and again until we have more experience automatically when we contact any moment, anywhere, any place, any time, right? Akaliko, ehipasiko, opanayiko. Pachatang vetitapo, we can prove this on, นะครับ, on jhana, we can be proved in the laboratory room or in on the road or on the farm or in the industry, นะครับ, building or in the university or live with a student or not. When we live, we have already about the power of enlightenment we call the three jhana as a truth that shown by the Lord Buddha. There is only one thing that the Buddha give to the sentient beings to remove the suffering by our own power, ourselves. He taught already step by step, that's one. Yeah. Please have more idea. Maybe share together, discuss together, please. I show you the suffering, yeah? One picture. So we can enlighten how to be confident that we have the power of enlightenment in our life. The way to inspire us to achieve the state of non-suffering, the hurry, time, hurry, energy that we have to complete our suffering, we have to start it with the first jhana of understanding correctly the Four Noble Truths. Until we know that birth is suffering, birth is not just only one life from our mother, right? Birth by body birth, but birth in the wrong view of attachment, of it ego or super ego. The Buddha taught already the four elements, soil element, right? Water element, air element, no? Five element, consciousness element, or empty element, that they depend on each other by way of cause and effect. They are impermanent. They are suffering. They are selflessness, right? If we know them at the root of the nature of life, we have to follow this. We cannot avoid this phenomena. But we face this. We learn from this. We know that suffering may be occur when we have wrong view, wrong understanding, wrong idea, wrong behavior, to start with ignorant desire attachment in this one. And then we may have suffering in any time. Show at any time. The suffering can be attack us any time. So the way to fight with the big boss of desire attachment or ignorant we have to search a good friend, right? The friend who have more inspiration, to have more power of meaning of life, to fight with wrong system of practice. นะครับ we call the practice of suffering. So the Buddha talks about two contents. The first content, the content of suffering. The suffering and cause suffering are the noble. Why the noble? Because are very important that we have to realize that we have this or not. If we have this, what to do? For the second part of contents, the Buddha talking about non-suffering, nirodha state, and the right path, the right way to do, to concern, to regard to any phenomena that we have correctly. We not born to be the one who have suffering forever, but we have the power or authority power to realize, to develop, to have more potentiality to understand the connection of this holistic suffering, physical and mental suffering, to know the cause and then to know the aim of life. The aim of life without the third and the fourth noble truth, that is the meaning of learning the Buddha teaching, right? We have all this suffering. But the Buddha not give us only the condition of suffering and non-suffering, but he gave us the root and the tools that we have to apply, right, to realize, to remove from suffering, suffering from our life. That's a very important, นะครับ has been removed, right? Nirodha, cessation suffering has been revealed, right? And the path to cessation of suffering has been practiced. We has been practiced means we pass, we have experience. The more we have experience, the more we have skillful to overcome the obstacle or the object or the temptation to have more greed or have more hatred or have more delusion. The boss of desire attachment not allow apayaman or to attack us again and again, right? So the right way to fix them, to understand them, and to reduce them, to remove them, we call the noble of practice. We call the morality training, like a right livelihood, right action, or right livelihood, or right speed, right? That's our behavior to control our contact to any object that's contacting to us. And then we have more inside power of mindfulness, right? Effort means Mahasati Pathan, the four Mahasati Pathan, right? Mindfulness on the body, the feeling, the mind, or the what we call Dhamma, okay? We know Dhamma. When we know Dhamma, we have mindfulness. Oh, they are impermanent suffering and selflessness. Oh, okay, they are the factor that depend on each other, no self exists in those relations, just only phenomena of material and immaterial things that are nature, must be according to the natural law of three characteristics. We have to know them like that. And then we can start with little by little like this, and then we can cultivate what we call balamita. Dana balamita means we not to support greed by clinking a lot of property, money, and support desire attachment, right? But we have to reduce, use them correctly for quality of life, use them for the society donation support, what they support human quality of life, support the temple, support the monk for propagating, teaching, for spreading the Buddha teaching to the human being to wake them up. The donation we call dana. Giving the food to the monk or to other, we call dana. Sometimes we call dana, sila, and bhavana as layman life. we have money, property, we may start it with dana or giving, and then we have property, we have to control our conduct, we call sila, and the last one we call bhavana or mindfulness, both tranquility meditation or insight meditation, wisdom development, including in bhavana. So in Thai tradition, sometimes we call three as the middle way, dana, sila, and bhavana. Or as a monk, no concerning about property because they forsaking already. They're not concerned about property. They started with sila, samadhi, and panya. A morality, okay, mindfulness, concentration, and wisdom development. For layman being like us, layman ones like us, we have power, we have property, we have family, we have to manage. That's real. Our money correctly for quality of life of these concern are concerned. When that we feel very okay as a layman life, giving, dana, sila, we have your training and mental and wisdom training we call bhavana, only these that we call the Eightfold Path as the kichayana of the Eightfold Path that we have to cultivate or develop this middle path so as to achieve the state of non-suffering. Okay, anything to share together about this?
Yeah, I would like to mention something.
Yeah, please.
Because we are speaking about the suffering all the time, right?
Yeah.
Reducing suffering. But I think when it comes to the people in the West, people in the West would say that, oh, I'm not suffering. My life is still quite good, right?
Yeah.
I think they would think that suffering is like, oh, I don't have only like one arm or like one leg or something seriously happened to my life. I think it's important to speak about dukkha. And that dukkha has like this big range from heavy suffering and from like slightly not feeling good, right? So if it's too cold or if it's too hot, if I feel for myself it's too cold or it's too hot, can also already be like dukkha. I don't feel fine.
Yeah. Dukkha means cannot maintain itself forever in that state. They have to be changed, right?
That would be impermanence.
Yeah, based on the condition of cause and effect, or we call impermanent state.
Yeah.
The impermanent state, that means no self in that phenomena.
Yeah, that this is atta, right?
Suffering means the condition not be permanent state. They have to change based on the cause and effect. The ugly of this we call suffering. Ugly means the condition that rising and ceasing according to by way of cause and effect. And this phenomena also, you know, the storm at come to any state in America today, right?
Yes.
Okay. That is the cause and effect. Too cold, too hot, too warm, right?
Yeah.
We have to adapt our body to temperature, right?
Yeah.
If we not adapt, we have sick, right?
Yeah.
So why we call suffering? Because impermanent effect to the condition of cause and effect that cannot be maintained permanently itself. And the ugliness, that's those phenomena until body and mind, this body and mind also, no self. But if we clinging them with strong will as the self, we try to cling everything, positive, negative, and then the more they change, not by the way we desire attachment, we have suffering because they change by way of cause and effect as they are, right?
Yeah. But
so
I
we
think
have,
that,
yeah.
Yeah. I think that, you know, if you see the monks and they sometimes they live in bad conditions, right? Or
yeah,
not
yeah.
so good conditions, but they are not suffering. So they don't feel it as dukkha. But we, as normal lay people, we have much better conditionings. But we think that, oh, if the condition is not perfect, oh no, we need it better, and we are already like suffering again. So I think it's a lot of the state of the mind, of one's mind also.
Yes.
If I suffer or not. And the thing is also that the people, they don't realize that what is like really happiness, what is sukha. So they think always that sukha is coming from the outside. They need possession, this and that, and it does not come from the inside, from like meditation or from like listening to the Dhamma or whatever. And so they misunderstand like both things. They misunderstand that dukkha, because they see it as big suffering, but it's already like, if I not feel good, this already dukkha. And and the same thing with the sukha. So if the people don't know where their really happiness is coming from.
Oh yeah, I agree to you. This one also correct. Like the monk who can accept, right, suffering and non-suffering, because he employ the Four Noble Truths, the three yana practice in his way of life, so he can reduce suffering better than the lay people.
Yes.
He employed the middle way as the Buddhist tradition of practice, so he can accept the impermanent suffering and selflessness. So he reduce desire attachment more than the lay people, especially if he live in the West, most tradition of extreme in today we call scientific method, materialism, consumerism, and capitalism, right?
Yes.
They may cling to and invest and more about material treatment. But the monk, they employ both material and mental state to reduce both bodily suffering and mental suffering. We can compare that. Okay, he employed what the Buddha taught, so he can adapt himself better than them. Someone that cannot know this thing. I agree to you. That's thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Friend,
it's very
please.
Interesting. Very interesting to hear about that and to think about it and to just speak about that also.
Good. Let me have more detail talking together in this detail concerning the Buddha teaching, right?
อาจารย์ครับ I have question
yes yes please
about dukkha and makkha. So I'm not I have this experience, like if I get pain from like wound or tightness, and it's considered dukkha, right? Because I'm tiring. But what is the right makkha that should I use to like endure this? Like somebody can die for something to like pursue the perfection. So it's like, if I'm die because somebody trying to kill me, so what the right method that should I, what is the right view, or what is the right thinking that should I have, or I don't know.
If someone suicide himself, right?
No, it's like,
what
it's
you
like,
mean, you mean when you have suffering,
like if somebody has
suffering,
we get tired from something, like, until like sick or until dead. So it's like, what kind of method or what kind of thinking that should we use in Makkha, or in, because it's considered dukkha, right? And like some monk who can like sacrifice their life. So like they need to suffering from death, or like merely death, right? But What is the right thinking that make him be happy to do it or not suffering? Or they are suffering, but they are not, they can't endure it. I don't know.
Yeah. So sometimes they know only suffering and they don't know non-suffering, the true non-suffering state. I mean the coolness of my own nirvana. Nirvana means living at the present. Life can be continued without suffering. But if they don't know about the correct nirodha or non-suffering state, mean if they enlighten the Four Noble Truths correctly as the Buddha taught, they have more power to help other people to free from suffering by human power, okay, with human tradition of noble path. But if they don't know the Four Noble Truths, they know only two noble truths, suffering and cause of suffering, they thought they remove this life of suffering by suicide, kill himself, so as to achieve the state of next life. But they don't know also what, right, about their life. But in the Buddha, life, if we kill ourselves in this life or destroy ourselves or suicide or something with wrong understanding, they have both suffering, suffering in this life and suffering in next life, because they have the root of samsara. They cannot cut the cycle of suffering or samsara. Samsara, the cycle of the root of that is ignorant desire attachment, right? So they continue on the way of two noble truths, suffering and cause of suffering. But if he enlightened the four noble truths, he know that he avoid killing, because killing is suffering, because the sin, right? The morality, right? Destroy oneself and other people. Let other people suffering and convince them or support them to believe in wrong view, right? Destroy oneself and other people are suffering, right? But if they know more the third noble truth and the fourth noble truth, they know more that I can still the life, have the life, but this life is very cool, very calm, very clean, very clear, very freedom from non-suffering. This body can continue in the way that's very useful for oneself and for human being. He devotes this with loving kindness for helping the one who have suffering to reduce ignorant desire attachment, to heal the one, to touch the people, to solve as the cause of suffering. Mean ignorant desire to not kill himself or destroy himself. So we know that the one who know true noble truth, but not correct, nah? True noble truth, but wrong understanding, right? If he know, he have right understanding, suffering must be investigated and accept, right? And if he don't know the root of suffering must be destroyed, he don't know ignorant desire attachment at the root of suffering. So he remove himself from this life to next life. He have long view that next life better than this life. He enjoy. He enjoy following in the wrong practice. Destroy oneself, hurt oneself, other people are wrong, not correct way. So he know the field estate of the true noble truth, but not for the four noble truth. But if he follow the four noble truths of the Lord Buddha, he not harm himself, harm other people, right? Suffering. Bird is suffering, but when we control the bird, or bird mean having ignorant desire attachment in any, right, moment of thing at the cell. It ego or super ego, right? We suffering from this, right? So when we destroy, mean correctly, mean we just behave correctly, let be, let go in the way of cause and effect are, but be correct to contact, behave correctly to them correctly as they are, in right view, right understanding, right speed, right action, not harm, right, very useful, very beneficial, very calm, and very happy. The correct happy means not for harm themselves and for harm other people, right? And he can continue the life without suffering, but his rights are very useful to show the people to see the calm, the life of calm, the life of clean, the life of peace, the life of freedom. That is the symbol of enlightenment. So I think that Venerable Pra Ajahn need to know that he know only two parts of suffering, not the fourth one. He know the few aspect of the truth. So he have the wrong will to behave, to solve the problem in the wrong way. The more he follow in the wrong practice, the more he have the more and more suffering in this life and in next life. Time, yeah. Respect the Pra Ajahn. ได้นะครับโอเค after friends our student
สาธุครับสาธุ
กราบนมัสการครับเป็นงานพอดีพอสมควรนะครับ so I think it's okay to talk to get there
so deep เลยครับ
deep and chat to get there right next time for today we however as the tune very important we can study only this topic in our life and we can achieve the end of suffering we finish as the one who learn the dhamma of the Lord Buddha the one who follow right the Buddha teaching the one who need the freedom from suffering I wish that on student may be have benefit from our discussion and study together today นะครับNo question at all. No idea, no comment, right? Please.
If Ajahn.
Please, yeah.
Just okay. I did some simple reading.
Yeah.
This Sajjayana, there are two levels also, right? One is the worry and one is the insight.Insight through meditation practice.
Yeah, Sajjayana mean Sajjayana mean we enlighten the Four Noble Truths, accept the Four Noble Truths as they are.
Yeah.
Suffering, right?
Yeah.
Accept what suffering, right? Okay, this is suffering. We broken heart. Okay, we have suffering. We have the death. We have a lot of, we have suffering.We have business problem, we have suffering, right? When suffering arise, mental or physical suffering, we realize and accept, right? So this is also, if we see the suffering, we have both tranquility or insight meditation. Otherwise, we cannot see suffering. So when we apply the wisdom development as insight meditation or mindfulness development at the concentration,small concentration, have more level of concentration until support wisdom to see the Four Noble Truths as they are. That means apply already the insight meditation and tranquility meditation in the practice. Otherwise, we cannot see suffering, the cause of suffering, the cessation of suffering, and the right path leading to the cessation of sufferingcorrectly as the Buddha taught. If we lack of insight, if we lack of mindfulness, tranquility, meditation, if we lack of morality or we lack of giving or dana, we cannot have time or energy to see this. But this level may not enough to complete, right? We just know the Sajjayana, but we don't knowthe function, Kichayana, the second super knowledge. We know the next one, the Sajjayana, and we know the third one that we call the fruit or assessment that we have experienced to cope with this Four Noble Truths correctly or not, and complete our work or not. If we complete, we have no suffering, we realize suffering already,We destroy the truth of suffering already. We achieve the state of non-suffering already. We have cultivate the right way of practice leading to the cessation of suffering correctly or already that we declare that we complete นะครับ the suffering so we can call that we are enlightened one the follow enlightened ones
thank you Ajahn can I understand compare it to like Pariyat Patipat Patiwe
yes together
level right
now if we know Triyana and Four Noble Truths as the Buddha teaching we call Pariyat right
yeah
if we follow as the Satyayana, as Sakitayana correctly when practiced already in daily life, we call Patipata, Patipat, right?
Yes.
If we have checked that, we have already, we done already, we have experienced already, the third Katayana, we call Pativesatthamma. Yeah.
Okay, understand.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, today we maybe enough time, right, to talk about this topic together. Thank you very much for listening and talking together. See you next time. Namaskar, พระอาจารย์ครับขอบคุณครับ
Thank you so much, อาจารย์สวัสดีค่ะ
ขอบคุณทุกคนครับขอบคุณคุณเฮียวโก้ right ขอบคุณครับ
ขอบคุณครับอาจารย์
ขอบคุณ
See you
ครับ
next week. Oh no, next week I'm not there.